Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.1, Problem 10. This is Section 9.1, it's Problem 10. It says, based on your answers for problems 8 and 9, what would you say happens to the size of the sample as the level of confidence increases? And is there any reason why you wouldn't automatically make the sample as big as possible? So what happens to the size of the sample as the level of confidence increases? So if you remember, problem 8 said that if we wanted 95% confidence, the size of our sample was 62. And for problem 9, if we wanted 99% confidence, we wanted a little more confidence, the size of the sample that we would need to get that 99% confidence went from 62 up to 107. So it would seem that as you require more confidence, a higher level of confidence, you're going to need a bigger sample size. A bigger sample size can provide a higher level of confidence. So now this brings us to the second part of the question. Is there any reason you wouldn't automatically make the sample size as big as possible? Like, if bigger is better, why not make it really big right away? Well, there are a few reasons, and that would be expense or possibly danger. So if you're doing some market research, and you can get your sample by just calling people on the phone or sending them emails, if 800 is good, you might as well make it 8,000. It's not really any more expensive or any more dangerous. So market research, make it really big. But let's say you're tracking wildlife and you're tagging grizzly bears. Very dangerous. So if 10 grizzly bears is a big enough sample to give you the information that you need, 10 is a much better number than 12. And expense too. Let's say you're crash testing the new Mercedes and you can get your crash safety data for your confidence interval by crashing, say, 6 Mercedes. Better to do it with 6 than 9 or 10. So there are reasons why you wouldn't want to go as big as possible. Sometimes, again, market research that can be done over the phone or standing in front of shopping malls might as well go real big. But there are certainly many times when the expense involved, or possibly the danger, or maybe both, would make you limit it. You can figure out how much accuracy you really need for your study and figure out how big you need to make the sample to achieve the accuracy you're looking for and really not make it any bigger than that.